Now today, as you know, everything is all about digitalization. And for now, next on the agenda, we have a speaker that does not just work in the tech world, he actually lives this tech world. Allow me to do the introductions, let's make it formal. He has many years of experience driving digital transformation, as you can imagine. And his strong suit is not only expertise, but a true passion for what he does on a daily basis. He really admires and respects, appreciates all the beautiful ways that technology can make all of our lives not just smarter, but also easier. As head of corporate digitalization and automation at Krones, he leads the way in developing solutions to bring lasting change to the industry. One thing I know for a fact is that even though you are indeed very much at home in the digital world, he treasures those analog moments with his family, with his daughters, and those are the things that really inspire you and ground you, is something I've learned about you. So today, everyone, I'm about to clear the stage and hand it over to him. He's going to be sharing how Krones' central digital platform is helping production environments become more transparent, become better connected, and future ready. So let's all pay close attention. This is for all of us. Please give a round of applause for Severin Diepold.
Thank you so much, Lizzie. Thank you so much. And also from my side, warm welcome. Wow, it's exciting to be here and seeing all you guys. Being back on drinktec, and I just remember 3 years ago where we started with a vision and what's now on the drinktec. It's incredible. It's unbelievable what not only my team, but the complete Krones team has achieved so far. And this makes me so proud. So today, I definitely want to focus a little bit on the Krones world, as you have already heard. This is our central platform, the new platform, basically, where all digital tools come together into one platform. And in this platform, we try to seamlessly integrate everything. So the OT, the IT, everything which is basically around in the metaverse, the digital metaverse of a Krones machine line. But even when you have a complete plant, everything which is involved is part of this, or should be part of this Krones world. And I definitely want to take you on a journey to explain a little bit, in particular, when we talk about the Krones world production, what we have in mind and what we basically developed so far. So let's jump to my first slide in the presentation in order to give you some more insights what we have developed in the Krones world production. So as you can see, and my previous group explained it already, there are three parts. First, the shopping part. Second, the production part. And third is the customer service part. And the production part means basically we connect your asset, your machine, your line, or even your complete plant to our ecosystem, to the Krones world. And by connecting, we generate a lot of new solutions on the one hand, but also opportunities in terms of changing the business model. We can consult, we can optimize, we can support our customers even better by having this connectivity. And basically, the Krones World Production is the collaboration platform between us on the one hand, but on the other hand, of our customers. So there is a single entrance point. So wherever you are, on the left-hand side, you can see any browser is basically suitable. Wherever you are, you need a browser, you need your credentials, you can log in. Or when you're in front of the machine, you can easily utilize one of the HMIs. So we have basically two HMIs, two machines already equipped with these new HMIs. It's the packer on my left side, and also our labeler from Cosme, where we have this new HMI. It's completely browser-based. The Krones world is completely integrated. And by logging in, you have access to all the opportunities which are basically in this Krones world available. So this means basically wherever you are, you have access to this platform, but not only you as a customer, but also on our side, our service technicians, our service hotline, everyone who has expertise has basically access and can support whenever you need it. So this brings me basically to the architecture, what is needed to connect your asset to this Krones world. So first you need a certain, we call it smart hardware device. So it's a hardware device, which is an IPC, but also our new HMI, which is basically needed. This is the preparation, let me say, that your machine or your line is capable to get connected. Second, we need a service agreement, which is already introduced. We call it Connect and Secure contract. That's basically the legal requirements we need, that you give us the approval that your machine can be connected. So once the machine is connected and onboarded to the Krones World Production, you have access and you will see your machine page. And within this machine page, you can basically manage your machine. But on the right-hand side of the slide, you can also see our Krones Digital Operations Center has access to the machine and actively manages your machine in terms of IT and OT. So we have heard about the Cyber Resilience Act, which is particular in Europe, a big thing. And it's really, yeah, we need to manage, we need to update, we need to patch the IT, but also the OT, which is in our machines. And this is something we want to do for you as a customer. We want to do this in a partnership. And this is exactly what our Digital Operations Center is doing. On top, of course, you can purchase our software as a service solutions as you like. For example, if you want to utilize our advanced analytics, which is a tool which is showcasing or showing you the OEE of your line, then you can purchase it whenever you need it. If you don't need it, you don't retain the subscription, and then you don't have to use it anymore, or you don't use it anymore. But we have also so-called data-driven consultants. So we have also consultants. They can analyze your data by using this platform. And then based on this data, they can consult you and support you to increase, of course, efficiency, but also in terms of how you maintain your asset. So this is basically the framework of our Krones world and what is needed to integrate your asset into the Krones world. And with that, let me come to the next slide. You need the asset, you need the contract, which we call Connect and Secure. Once you have the contract in place, we start with the onboarding process. So in the background, we have a database where basically all our machines which are under management are registered, where we do kind of an onboarding process. And then, of course, once the machine is onboarded in the Krones world, our Digital Operations Center can manage the machine and support you in the background, in the background, basically, to keep your machine up to date. And basically, the Digital Remote Center, this is a team. We have set it up three locations worldwide. There's one location in Europe, there's one location in China, and one in North America. And these teams are supporting our customers 24/7 in order to keep your assets up and up to date. And up to date means always secure, but also always ready for production in order to avoid that there are any downtimes because of technical issues. And to make this more concrete, I brought some slides, some mock-ups. And this is basically, once you logged into the Krones World Production, your machine page. As you can see here, there's the machine. You can see on the machine, is the machine connected to Krones, yes or no? And is the machine actively under management of Krones? And of course, there's a nice picture of your machine. You can easily jump directly to your HMI. As I said, wherever you are, you can also jump to your HMI from any browser, basically, and look up what's happening in this machine. You see, is my Connect and Secure contract still valid, or is it extending, or do I need to renew it? And of course, you see also a lot of IT and OT components. And this is basically on the right side, and there are some red and green dots. This means basically, in this case, our Siemens SPS or PLC has not the latest firmware upgrade or update. This means basically, if we are continuing with that, there's maybe a certain cybersecurity risk. And this basically shows our customers that there is action needed. And in the next step, it's really easy for our customers. They just open up the second page. And as you can see, we distinguish between three areas. This is the firmware upgrade. This is the project. And there are the configurations. And as you might know, in the PLC, there is a lot of project-specific development needed. This is something we will not update by mass updates. However, the firmware update, this is definitely something we want to update as a mass update to our customers. So we get, for example, in this case, the new version of the firmware from Siemens. We do internal checks, we test, we do the validation, and then our digital operations team push this firmware to the platform. And as you can see, by just pushing a button, our customers can download this firmware from Krones to the IPC, and then with a second push, and I'm going to show you this here, the system will ask our customers, are you sure that you want to update from the COP now your Siemens PLC, because this will cause downtime. So basically, the customer has the last button in order to confirm, yes, I definitely, I'm sure. And in this case, this will take 40 to 50 minutes. So be aware that in the next 40 to 50 minutes, the machine will update. And then by pushing that, the machine will update immediately, automatically. And then, of course, the machine has the latest and greatest and most secure firmware again. And that's basically how we want to organize and manage the fleet of machines out there. And by doing that, we believe we support our customers in the best way. This is the example I brought today. I think it's very impressive. And I definitely want to invite everyone here in the booth. Check or go by to one of our machines where we have prepared this kind of showcases. We're working on that. And of course, we are also very much in discussion with you guys as our customers to discuss, is this fits this your requirements? Is this something you want to do? Or is this maybe a way we should not continue because you say we want to do it completely different? Then please feel free, give us the feedback. This is exactly what exhibition is all about. Getting feedback, learn from our customers. And with that said, I already come to my almost last slide. So it's really unbelievable how many digital solutions we have now ready. And this is what I explained to you before. These are our digital services which are available in the Krones world. Contiloop AI, Shopfloor Guidance, Advanced Analytics, Energy and Media, just to name some of them. So our portfolio of digital products is growing and growing. And you as a customer, you can decide whatever you would like to have. Go for it for a 1-year subscription. If you don't like it, don't continue. So it's up to you. And with that, I'm really excited. I would like to thank you. Let's enjoy this drinktec week, and I'm looking forward to great discussions. Thank you so much from my side, and all the best.